Welcome to my video. So in this video we discuss about group transfer polymerization. It's a new type of polymerization reaction. In here the transfer of one group from initiator site to the monomer site and forms the polymerization, that is called as group transfer polymerization. So in 1983 they developed the GTP, group transfer polymerization, at Dupont Wilmington. Using group transfer polymerization, we can synthesize or polymerize the narrow molecular weight distribution, means having the MN bar, means number molecular weight, having a narrow molecular weight can be can get the narrow molecular weight distribution compounds can be polymerized. So in here group transfer means transfer of one group from initiator site to the monomer site. So we discussed that in the example of methyl methacrylate, or in the polymerization of in the compound of polymethyl methacrylate. So it will be the methyl methacrylate can be polymerized having the number average molecular weight around 4300 with poly dispersity, where the poly dispersivity dispersity means MW bar divided by MN bar. So its ratio should be 1.24, or the poly dispersity should be 1.24. It can be synthesized in the group transfer polymerization reaction. So in here one thing is important, it is an exothermic reaction, hence the liberated heat is sufficient to carry the reactions. Hence the reaction always takes place under room temperature only, no other external heat should be required. So in here the group transfer by the help of initiator or group transfer initiator catalyst, and using these a monomer can be polymerized. So in here organosilicon as initiator and bifluoride as catalyst. So first, before that, discuss about the catalyst. Normally the catalysts are bifluorides, means HF2-. So in here, bifluoride as catalyst. The bifluorides are tridimethylaminosulfonium bifluoride. Bifluoride as an catalyst. Tridimethylaminosulfonium bifluoride as an catalyst. So in here generally, or we can as HF2- acts as an catalyst. And the organosilicon as initiators. Organosilicons means silicon bonded with the organic moieties. Like the example of group transfer initiators are ethyl trimethyl silyl acetate. So in here these are the important or the transfer group or trimethyl silyl group. Similarly in here trimethyl silyl acetate, trimethyl silyl cyanide. So these SiCH3CH3CH3 is an transfer group or group, therefore it's called as group transfer polymerization. Transfer of trimethyl silyl group from initiator site to the monomer site. Similarly, another one of best example for group transfer initiator is 1-methoxy, in here 1-methoxy, 1-trimethyl siloxy, 2-methyl propene. So that is called as the best example for the initiator used in the group transfer polymerization. Uh, In here, the THF as an best solvent means the catalyst may activate the initiators. That's only. These catalysts, in the above catalyst, bifluoride catalyst, to activate the trimethyl silyl acetate or the trimethyl compounds. And in the presence of THF solvent, and these solvent can be precipitated by the help of methanol. Means after complete the reaction, we can add the methanol, which acts as a precipitating reagent. It will be precipitate the given polymer chains. So we can discuss about the mechanism group transfer polymerization using these initiator as well as catalyst. So in here, the best example is trimethyl siloxy compounds like CH3 double bond C, OSRCH3 thrice OCH3. So in here I will hear 1 methoxy, 1 trimethyl siloxy, 2 methyl propene will combines with the, that is the initiator or group transfer initiator, combines with the methyl methacrylate in here the monomer having the carbonyl compounds, because in the mechanism, the transfer of trimethyl silyls means SiCH3 group, trimethyl silyl group, from initiator to the monomer site, in which place, it means it's a carbonyl carbonyl oxygen groups of the monomer site. Hence, the monomer must containing the carbonyl compounds, then only we can explain the group transfer polymerization. Means the monomer must having the carbonyl compounds, then only it can be polymerized under group transfer polymerization reaction. So in here the mechanism is the trimethyl silyl group transferred to the monomer site or end of the incoming monomer site of carbonyl oxygen compounds. That takes place the transfer of trimethyl silyl group to the C double bond O groups. So we can discuss that in here when added to these trimethyl silyl will added to that the methyl methacrylate, and it forms the in the presence of bifluoride as catalyst. We can add this. So we can write here CH3. We can to that carbon atom we can add it to this like CH2. Due to that, add in here transfer to that, and due to the addition, the double bond shifted to that side, and it will be shifted to that. Hence, it is in the form of CH2 single bond, double bond converts to single bond, CH3 C single bond O minus, clear, OCH3 C double bond O, 1, 2, 3 double bonds, CCH3 double bonds, C OCH3, and to that carbon we can add it to that C double bond O, clear, OCH3. In here it will, due to shifted that O minus, this SiCH3 plus group, it will shifted to the SiCH3 thrice. See here, due to the shifting that, it will added to that compound, these trimethyl silyl group to that and added to these compounds. Hence, trimethyl silyl group will transfer to the initiator site to the carbonyl oxygen of the monomer site forms the initiation reaction. That is methacrylate. So, or it can be written in the form of CH3O C double bond O C CH3 CH2 C CH3 double bond C O S I CH3 thrice O CH3. See here, if these compounds will be written in that side, COO, COO, CH3, C, CH3, CH2, CCH3 double bond, COO, SiCH3, OCH3. So that is the initiation reaction. Next, move on to the propagation reaction. In a propagation reaction, we can add these compounds. We can I write here. Again, we can add the fresh monomer methyl methacrylate. C CH3 C double bond O O CH3. In here again we can add it to the double bonds, and again due to the bond formation it shifted to that side, and simultaneously double bond shifted to that side O minus, these group will shifted to that side. Hence we can write the propagation reaction CH3 O C double bond O C CH3 CH3 CH2 C CH3. Clear? Now we can add it to this compound. Here CH2, I write here CH2 single bond C single bond C CH3 CH3 double bond. Clear? C O minus, and the transferred compounds CH3 thrice OCH3 next OCH3, and to that 1 2 3 these carbon containing the single bond, again C double bond O C double bond O OCH3. That is the propagation reaction. Continue these. Next, added n number of methyl methacrylate. Methyl methacrylate. Again, it will be added to. And these O minus shifted to that side. And it shifted to that, and O minus, these SiCH3 group transport to that. Hence we can write CH3O C double bond O C CH3 CH3 CH2 C CH3 C double bond O O CH3 n times CH2 C CH3 CCH3 double bond C O minus SI CH3 thrice O CH3. That is the, so in here the methyl monomer containing the CH2 CCH3 COOCH3. Clear? Sorry, CCH2 COOCH3. So again CH2 CCH3 COOCH3 n times monomer containing n number of methyl methacrylate. That is the propagation reaction. The last one is termination. In here the termination, it is an in the group transfer polymerization reaction, is like anionic polymerization reaction. just like anionic polymerization reaction. In here, the trimethyl siloxy group means OSICH3, that is SICH3 thrice, that is the trimethyl silyl group in here containing OSICH3 thrice, trimethyl siloxy end group having the most active species, or it is an living, it's just like an anion having the O minus. These O minus added to the next contest. That's why it is an living polymerization. It is an living polymer, means the trimethyl siloxy is most active components and it cannot be terminated. That's also called it as the group transfer polymerization, is also nothing but living polymerization reactions. So in here, based on that, we can using these type of polymers, we can narrow molecular weight can be polymerized from group transfer polymerization reactions. Clear? In here, the advantages of GTP or group transfer polymerization is just like an anionic polymerization, means the O minus SiCH3 plus mole active components, hence it is an anionic, just like an anionic polymerization. Anionic polymerization is also nothing but living polymerization reaction, and it does not require external temperature. Already we explained, because of it's an during the transfer of SiCH3 thrice group, means a trimethyl silyl group, the heat will be liberated, or it's an exothermic reaction, and due to that, the exothermic reaction, it liberates heat, that liberated heat enough to the carry the reactions. Hence, it does not require external temperature, means the reaction takes place at lower temperature or room temperature only. And next is, it produces perfect control molecular control polymer end groups, means OSICH3 thrice group, it's controlled polymer end groups, and polymer having good poly dispersity. So these are the advantages of group transfer polymerization reactions. Clear? So then what are the monomers can be polymerized? So in here, the monomers containing the carbonyl compounds, I already explained things. So one is N-butyl methacrylates. So CCH3CH3COOOCH, N-butyl methyl acrylate. Clear? Methyl acrylate, one of the example. Another one is NN-dimethyl acrylamide. So in here again, the transfer of the O SiCH3 thrice group in the C double bond O, in here C double bond O. Similarly, methyl acrylate. If it is CCH3 means methyl methacrylate, in here CH2 double bond CHCOCH3 is methyl acrylate. And methyl vinyl ketones. Methyl vinyl ketones, COCH3, that is ketone, ketonic group. Methyl vinyl ketone. Again, the transfer of trimethyl silyl group to that in that compounds. So already the given the problems, not only the initiators are trimethyl silyl cyanide, again in here SiCH3CH3 thrice will transfer to the end of the monomeric site. You can try this monomer under group transfer polymerization reactions. So the same same thing in here, in the every cases the initiator added to these compounds again shifted to the double bonds CO minus, and O minus SiCH3 thrice group will be added to that, and it continue the reactions. So I hope you understand this concept of group transfer polymerization reaction and try this as assignment. Thank you for watching my video.